गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल बी गोइंग थ्रू फ्यू ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस विद रेस्पेक्ट टू दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. राइट डाउन द फॉर्मूले ऑफ सोडियम ऑक्साइड, एल्यूमिनियम क्लोराइड, सोडियम सल्फाइड, मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. स्टूडेंट्स, टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द फॉर्मूले, द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट यू नीड टू रिमेम्बर इज टू नो इट्स वेलेंसी. इफ यू नो द कंबाइनिंग कैपेसिटी and the symbol of the elements, then it becomes very easy for you to construct the chemical formulae. Now for first one, sodium oxide. Sodium, it is Na, oxide or oxygen, it is O. Now the valency of sodium is +1, oxygen is -2. When you crisscross the valency, you get Na2O. Second one, aluminium chloride. For aluminium, it is +3 and for chlorine, it is -1. So, when you crisscross the valency, you get aluminium chloride, that is AlCl3. Here, next one, sodium sulfide. Sodium, it is +1. Sulfide, it is -2. When you crisscross the valency, it is Na2S. Then, why are we writing OH in bracket? Over here, you will understand. It's a polyatomic ion. Now, here Mg valency is 2 and OH it is -1. I have told you, if when you crisscross the valency, suppose if OH was just 1, then there was no need for us to put this bracket. Since it is 2, we are putting it inside the bracket and we are writing it as 2, MgOH2. Remember, polyatomic ion, if it is more than 1, you need to put it inside the bracket. Next, how many atoms are present in H2S molecule and PO3-4 ion? H2S molecule, just count. Hydrogen is 2 and your sulfur is 1. So 2 plus 1 is 3. And over here, forget about 3 minus. We just need to count how many number of atoms are there. So atoms are, phosphorus is 1. And oxygen is 4. So 4 plus 1 is 5. Calculate the formula unit mass of zinc oxide and Na2O and K2CO3. The formula unit mass to calculate, you need to know the atomic mass. Okay, we have worked out several problems with respect to this. Now, zinc oxide. What is atomic mass of zinc? It is 65U plus oxygen, it is 16. 65 plus 16, it is 81U. Then Na2O. Sodium is 23, since there are two atoms of Na, we are multiplying it by 63 into 2 plus 16 into 1. So finally, we will get it as 62U. Same with K2CO3. Okay. We see potassium, it is 39 into 2 because there are 2 atoms of potassium plus carbon, it is 12 into 1, 16 into 3. So when you add it up, you get 138U. Please calculate it. Now next, if 1 mole of carbon atom weighs 12 gram, what is the mass of 1 atom of carbon? Students, whenever they ask you to calculate the mass of 1 atom, 2 atom, 3 atom, it means they are asking you for the number of particles. They are asking you for the number of particles. And always you need to remember is 1 mole is equal to atomic mass or molecular mass in grams. And it has got Avogadro number of particles. And this atomic mass or molecular mass in grams has Avogadro number of particles. One more important thing, molecular mass is also known as molar mass. Now they are asking us to find out what is the mass in grams of one atom of carbon. It means the number of particles. Now, first step is, if 1 mole of carbon atom weighs 12 gram, so 1 mole of carbon atom, okay, it weighs 12 grams. And we know 12 grams contain so many number of particles or so many number of atoms. Now they are asking one atom. When I say one atom, it is nothing but a particle. So below this I am writing one atom and I have to calculate what is the mass. Then when I crisscross it, what is happening is finally the value what I get is 1.99. Please don't try to simplify 10 to the power of 23. Just keep it as it is. When you are taking it on top, it will become minus. Otherwise, it will remain positive. If it was on top, it would have remained positive. I'll repeat this once again. Now, what are they asking? What is it that we know? We know that 1 mole of carbon atom weighs 12 grams. So we know 1 mole of carbon atom weighs 12 grams and we also know 12 gram contains Avogadro number of particle, that is 6.022 into 10 power of 23 atoms or particles are present. If you check the atomic mass of carbon, it will be 12. Okay, this is nothing but the atomic mass in gram of carbon and it has got so many number of particles. Now they are asking what is a mass in grams. They are asking you this. Remember, it is mentioned in the question, what is atomic mass in grams of one atom of carbon. One atom of carbon. When they say one atom, two atom, it is just referring to the particle. So these are the atoms or the particles. So below this you are writing one atom. This is what is unknown. You cross multiply and you will get this answer. Next, which has more number of atoms, 100 gram of sodium or 100 gram of iron? Okay, given atomic mass of sodium is 23U and iron is 56U. I will teach you the formula method and also how to simplify without using the formula also. Now, what they are asking you, we need to find out which has got more number of particles or more number of atoms. We know that sodium, we know atomic mass in gram of sodium is 23. Okay, it has got so many number of particles. Now they are asking how many particles are there in 100 gram. So you just have to cross multiply. Okay. Now, either you simplify it and keep it up to 10 to the power of 23, or if you want to shift the decimal, then when you are shifting it this side, if you are shifting the decimal, then you will get it as 24. You can leave the answer just like that. 26.17, you can leave it just like that, or if you want to shift the decimal, you can shift it and you will get it as 24 atoms. Same here. Now, what is the atomic mass of iron? It is 56. And how many number of particles it has got? 6.022 into 10 power of 23. Now, 100 grams of iron, how many particles does it have? We cross multiply and we get so many atoms. Okay, compare which has got more number of atoms. So, we see 100 gram of sodium has more number of atoms and 100 gram of iron. Okay, and if you don't want to do this method, use this particular method, this particular formula. Number of atoms you want to calculate. Okay, that is N is equal to what is a given mass, that is 100 over here, divided by molar mass. Molar mass is nothing but it is atomic mass or molecular mass in grams, that is M, into Avogadro number, that is N naught. So this is a formula to find out the number of atoms or number of particles. This formula can be used or you can use this direct method. Now, what is a mass of 1 mole of nitrogen atom? We know 1 mole of nitrogen is equal to atomic mass or molecular mass in grams. So it is 14U atomic mass. If I need to convert it into grams, it will be 14G. How about 14 moles of aluminium ions? 1 mole we know. Atomic mass of aluminium ion, it is 27 gram. If I say mass of 4 moles of aluminium atom, then it will be 27 into 4. 1 mole we know. We need for 4 moles. So 27 is the atomic mass into 4. We get 108. Now, mass of 1 mole of sodium sulfide. Formula is Na2SO3. First, find out what is the molecular mass. They are asking you 10 moles. Whatever answer you have obtained, no? Into 10. So, you will get it for 10 moles. Now, convert into moles. Either you can do it by formula method or by direct method. You have to convert this 12 gram of oxygen, 20 gram of water and 22 gram of carbon dioxide into mole. See, over here oxygen is, we know that students, we will calculate now for this oxygen O2. Now, O2, let us calculate the molecular mass, that is 32 gram per mole. Now, we know that 1 mole is 12 gram. Sorry, 1 mole is 32 grams per mole. Now, they are asking for 12 grams, how many moles? We have to convert it into moles. So, you can cross multiply. You can cross multiply. And when you cross multiply, you will get this answer. 0.375 mole. Okay. Either you can do the formula method. Number of moles is equal to given mass divided by molar mass. Molar mass is nothing but atomic mass or molecular mass in grams. So, you will get the same answer. This is a formula method. Now, let's do for 20 grams of water. Let me teach you the direct method. Then, I will teach you the formula method. The formula is the same formula. Given mass divided by molar mass. Now, for water, we have to calculate the molecular mass. Okay, 1 mole contains water. 1 into 2 is 2 plus 16. So, it is 18. So, 1 mole contains 18 gram. Okay. This is nothing but atomic mass or molecular mass in grams. Then, so for 20 grams, how many moles? Cross multiply. So, you will get this answer. Same thing, you have to do it with carbon dioxide also and you will get this answer, or do it by the formula method, direct substitution, to calculate the number of moles. So hopefully it is clear. You can work out more number of problems for better understanding.